Hello children, today we have come up with a new chapter number 3, A Jester's Challenge. A Jester's Challenge. Open page number 20 in your textbook, listen to the video and follow it. So let's begin the lesson. A Jester's Challenge. So what do you mean by jesters, children? Jesters is also known as clown or a joker or a buffoon. Okay, jesters mean a joker or a clown. So what is the learning point in this lesson? Pride makes a person overconfident. Overconfident leads to downfall. Means the person who is very proud will be very much overconfident, and this overconfident leads to the ruin or loss. So let's start the lesson. There was once a great scholar named Sardappa. He was widely respected as a scholar and was lauded for his wisdom even by kings. Unfortunately, Sardappa was too proud of his wisdom. So there was once a great scholar. There was once a great Pandit or Jnani whose name was Sardappa. He was respected, he was extensively, widely respected as a scholar, as a Pandit, and was praised or admired for his knowledge even by the king. Then unfortunately, Sardappa was very proud of his knowledge. One fine day, he put on a gold necklace studded with sparkling gems around his neck and marched haughtily to the royal palace of a neighboring kingdom. He walked straight into the king's court and said loudly and cockily, "Whoever can defeat me in wisdom will get this necklace of fine gems. This is my challenge." So one day what happened? Sardappa, he put a gold necklace. So he put a gold necklace and studded with, which is studded means which is filled with, densely filled with the sparkling, brightly shining gems around his neck. So he put a gold necklace around his neck and he marched haughtily. So with full of pride, with arrogantly, he went to the royal palace of neighboring country, means next kingdom. He went there and he walked straight into the king's court. He walked straightly to the king's court and said loudly and with overconfident, he said loudly, "Whoever can defeat me," so whoever will defeat me, so in wisdom, in my knowledge, whoever will defeat me will get this necklace of fine gems, and this is my challenge. The scholars in the court knew that Sardappa was a man of intelligence. They were certain that they would fail miserably if they took up the challenge, so they didn't come forward. The scholars in the court, means the Pandit in the court of that kingdom, they all know that Sardappa is a man of intelligence. So he is very intelligent, and they also know that if they take a challenge, then definitely they are going to terribly, they are going to fail. So that is why nobody came forward. "How sad, there is no one in my court to take up Sardappa's challenge," the king thought. Now the king thought himself that how sad it is, nobody in my court is ready to take Sardappa's challenge. Now who is going to take the challenge? Suddenly, to everyone's astonishment, the court jester stood up and said, "I will accept your challenge." Suddenly, to the surprise of everyone, the jester, the court jester, the jester who who is in the court, he stood up and said, I am going to accept your challenge. The joker who was in the court, he said that I am going to take the challenge. The king, who had almost accepted the defeat, was surprised at the jester's courage. He knew that the jester was only a joker and would not be able to win challenge. He didn't have any hope on the jester. Yet he thought it would be amusing to see him compete with Sardappa. So now the king, he already had accepted, almost he accepted the defeat. Okay, children, he had almost accepted the defeat, and now he was surprised to see the jester's courage. He was surprised to see the courage of the jester, courage of the joker. He knew that he was known that the jester is only a joker and he cannot able to win the challenge. But he also didn't have any hope on the jester. He didn't have any hope. The king didn't have any hope on the jester. But he thought like it is a funny to see he is going to compete with the Sardappa. That is a man of intelligence. It is very funny to see the jester going to compete with Sardappa. The court jester came forward a little shyly and said, Shriman, I will ask you 4 questions. If you answer any of my questions correctly, you will lose. But if all your answers are incorrect, I will accept defeat and our king will give you anything you ask for. Now, the jester came forward. He comes little forward with shyly. He'll come and he says to Sardappa that, Shriman, I am going to ask you 4 questions. Now I'm going to ask you 4 questions. Now if you answer correctly of any of my 1 question, if you answer correctly, you will lose. So you're not supposed to answer correctly. So if all your answers are incorrect, if you are answering, I mean if all the answers are not proper or not correct, then I am going to accept the defeat and our king will give whatever you ask ask for. Now everyone in the court watched the jester in stark silence. Sardappa raised his eyebrows and looked at the jester with amusement. Does one need to be intelligent to give wrong answers? Ask as many questions as you can, he said with a wry smile on his face. So now everyone in the court who's present now watched Chester in a stark silence. They were full of silence and they watched the jester. And Sardappa raised his eyebrows and looked at the jester with amusement. Sardappa looked at the jester with funny. Who is he? Somebody to need to be intelligent to give wrong answer? For giving a wrong answer, do we need to be intelligent? Ask how many questions you can. You can ask me any questions and ask as per you can, he said with a wry smile on his face. That is with an irritating or with a crooked or a dry smile on his face. Then jester asked the questions to Sardappa. Where do you come from, Shriman Sardappa? The jester put his first question. What is the jester's first question? Where do you come from? So where are you coming from? Said to Sardappa. So now, can anyone accept a better question from a jester? Sardappa said to himself. Sardappa said to himself that, can anybody expect the other better question from the joker? Nobody. So he chuckled and said, so he laughed quietly, insidely. He laughed and he said, I live here. So I live here. So he said the wrong answer. And that was incorrect. Since he came from the neighboring kingdom, by giving the wrong answer, Sardappa got through the first question. So that was incorrect, right? He doesn't stay here. He stays in some neighboring kingdom. But the Sardappa says the wrong, incorrect answer. By saying the incorrect answer, by giving the wrong answer, Sardappa passed the first question. Now, what is the second question? The jester then put his second question, how long have you been here? 3 years, Sardappa answers without any hesitation. This was also incorrect. The jester was unable to trick him even with his second question. Now the jester asked him the second question, how long you have been here? So Sardappa, without any hesitation, he says that I'm staying here since from 3 years, and it is incorrect. And he, now the jester, for in second questions also, he is not able to trick the Sardappa. The third time, the jester meekly asked, our king is good, kind and generous. Do you agree? The third time the jesters asked that our king is very good, he's very kind and he's very generous. Do you agree? Then Sardappa shouted, your king, what are you saying? Your king is wicked and cruel. Because he has to say wrong answer, so Sardappa says that, no, your king, what are you saying? Your king is not good, he is wicked and he is very cruel. So saying, Sardappa won again, for the king was known for his generosity and kindness. Again, so by saying this, again Sardappa won, because the king was very generous, very kind and is very good person. So he had to give wrong answer. So Sardappa gave wrong answer, and now even the third question he passed. It seems like I can't defeat you, the jester said sheepishly. Means now the jester said softly or with a lack of confidence. He didn't have a confidence at all, because all the three answers he gave incorrect. He was supposed to give incorrect answers, and he gave incorrect answer and he passed. So that is why, with lack of confidence and without the confidence, jester said, no, I think you are going to defeat me. Joker said that, no, I think Sardappa is going to defeat me. Now this made Sardappa swell with pride. So by hearing this, what the jester speaks now. So he, by hearing this, so he, the Sardappa went with, rise with pride. Proud, he became very much proud now. Now, jester, by the way, how many questions have I asked you so far? Asked the jester very casually. You have asked me three questions, and you have one more chance. If you do not answer even that correctly, you will lose, Sardappa said immediately, reminding him the condition of the challenge with a stern face. Now, with very casually, the joker, the jester asked, now, by the way, how many questions I have asked you so far? How many questions I have asked you still now? Now suddenly, without a thought, without thinking, Sardappa replied him that, no, you have asked me three questions. Now you have only one chance. I am not going to answer correctly, and then you are going to lose. Sardappa, without thinking, he uttered everything. So he said everything. Now immediately, so he reminded all the condition which Joker, that is Jester, said with a serious face. Look, look, Shriman Sardappa has lost. He has answered the fourth question correctly. The jester cried out in utter happiness and childlike innocence. So now the jester say, look, look, Shriman Sardappa has lost the challenge. Now he answered the fourth question correctly. So he was not supposed to answer correct answer, right? He was not supposed to give correct answer. So he answered correctly. So he lost the challenge. Now the jester cried out, means he said louder with a happiness and childlike innocence. Now Sardappa understood his folly immediately. Now Sardappa got to know his mistake immediately. He got to know. He looked down abashed. He realized how he got tricked by the jester. His pride was severely dented. Without a word, he unhooked his necklace and gave it to the court jester, which he in turn handed over to the king. Now he looked down. He felt ashamed and he bowed his head down. And then he realized, he got to know the mistake and how he tricked by the jester. How the jester tricked the Sardappa. Now his pride was severely dented. Now his proudness was severely damaged. Without a word, he unhooked his necklace. So he removed his necklace and gave to the court jester. So now the court jester, he in turn handed over to the king. He handed over the necklace to the king. Having been overcome by a mere court jester, Sardappa felt disgraced. He said peevishly, I will never challenge anybody again. All the scholars in the court were very impressed by the jester's presence of mind. He had acted only like a clown until then, lightening the atmosphere in the court. They never expected him to be so clever. They wholeheartedly showered him with all praises for saving the pride of their kingdom. The jester humbly said, you see, even great scholars lose when they are not alert. Had Sriman Sardappa been alert, he would have won. So, having been overcome by a mere court jester, Sardappa felt disgraced. So having been defeated by the jester, by the court jester, he became very ashamed. Sardappa felt ashamed and he said with irritatedly, he said that I am not going to challenge anybody again. So all the scholars and all the pundits in the court, so they were very impressed. They were very happy for the jester's presence of mind, and he acted only like a clown. He acted like a joker and he lightened the atmosphere in the court, and nobody expected that even the joker could be so clever, and they wholeheartedly praised jester for saving the kingdom. So then the jester said, humbly said, see, even the great scholars, even the great pandit will lose when they are not alert. So always we have to be very alert. If we are not alert, if we are more proud about ourselves, definitely we are going to lose. If the Sriman Sardappa had been alert, he would have won. So if he would have been alert, he would have been won. So children, we should be confident, but we should not be overconfident. So overconfident makes us to commit the biggest mistakes in the simple situation. So some simple situation, it makes us to commit the biggest mistake. So always be confident but not overconfident. Okay, thank you children. So now I'm going to read a difficult words aloud. Listen to it. Lauded, astonishment, cockily, meekly, sheepishly, casually, abashed, tricked, disgraced, peevishly. Isn't it a beautiful story, children? Hope you all enjoyed the lesson. So practice the difficult words in your notebooks. Read it and write it. Take care. Bye-bye.